Hi guys. I've been extremely busy today. The table has shrunk. Mac just moved it. I now have the computer station. Not as high as I was hoping, but it works. At the moment, there's only power leads on two of those computers. Pardon me, I've just eaten. This Dell 4600 isn't connected at all, it's just under there for storage purposes. So I figured I've already got the Windows 2000 Dell there. And the Optiplex. It's an Optiplex? Yeah, Optiplex GX 60, I believe that says. That's all working. I've sort of ran short on kettle leads. I need at least three. One for the Windows Millennium, one for this Advent, and one for the Apple. Oh, and I need one more Ethernet lead, because all of those are connected. Pardon me. I just haven't done that one yet. None of these are plugged in because I haven't got enough sockets. I need another six-way at least. So I've only got two left up there. So I could plug in the two computers into there, and that's fine. So I would need one, two, three, four, five. Yeah. Six-way minimum. I've just got to reset the clock, because obviously I unplugged everything, because it was just easier to do it that way and then set everything back up. In the little shelf under the drawer, I've got the PS2 and the satellite receiver. I've got the Mega Drive on top, the DVD, VCR combo, and the PS1's under the bed. All connected up, so I've got to just turn them on. Yes, I've just got to get the fan off the bed. All this crap off the bed. That keyboard seemed to have failed, because I did try this earlier. In fact, what I could do, we could see if the internet actually works. I'll turn this on. Yeah, I had that black keyboard plugged into here to use here, and that was just constantly beeping. I don't think I connected the cable up in here, so internet won't work unless I do that. So, just bear with me a couple of seconds while I fish the cable into position and plug it in. Because I was absolutely right, I haven't plugged it in. There. Ooh. So, now by the time I boot up one of these machines. Oh, pardon me. Well, I've got lots of lights on. I've got no idea what the hell that monitor's doing. It's going click, clock, click, clock, click, clock. I've got quite a loud relay on it that likes to click on and off. I've just turned the GX 60. I believe that's 60 on there. It's a bit dark down here. Yeah. Pretty certain. I might put a 256 megabyte stick in there with the 512 just to bump the memory up a little bit. But for Windows XP, you've got to have a minimum of 1 gigabyte of memory to run AVG. I don't know about Avast or any other antivirus, but AVG, even though it's free, it still requires a minimum of a gigabyte. It will work below that, but it'll lag your computer like hell, because I've been there and tried that. My internet switch is quite noisy. Oh, But I know it's got fans either side of it. I just want to know if the switch is actually going to work. It should. I tested it before and it did work. I don't know why I keep bringing that up automatically. Oh. Unable to connect to the internet. That's probably because it hasn't connected yet. If it doesn't, I'm sure with a bit of fiddling around we can get it to connect. Showing that the plugs are plugged in. Should we see Firefox loads? Wasn't pushed into the back of the PC properly. There we go. So now if I refresh page, we have internet. It is working. Good. Could actually turn that other Dell on if I wanted to and run two at the same time, but it will let me. That's good. It's working. So I like how it flashes to let you know which one's active. Because this is the first one, this one. Oh, a threat, huh? Update. I might as well run an update while I've got it on. When it's thought about it. It's going to be a bit slow, so it's got less than a gigabyte on here. I just think that's to do its thing. Right. Meanwhile, in the lounge. Now, what did I do with that? The screwdriver I want is in here somewhere. I nearly went through there and forgot it, but I need it. Because it's magnetic. What have I done with that? I've opened up my new cutters, by the way. They're nice and sharp. Sort those CD racks out. I'm not sure where I'm going to put them, though. I want to stand them sort of in there. I mean, they'll easily move. I could just, well, I suppose I could pick those controllers up and plunk them up there. Installing updates. Good. Carry on installing your updates. Didn't actually take it through here, did I? Find a home for that. Yeah, because I'm having problems with this board. It's got a very weird beep that keeps coming from the buzzer, the onboard buzzer. If I nudge the video card in the slot, sometimes that'll stop working. And it does that no matter what video card I put in there, so even though I tested those other video cards, it may not have been an accurate test. So, I'm just going to move the ladder out of the way. That bloody server chassis is out on the landing, tucked up the corner out of the way. Right, so what I want to do with this, I'm going to go hunting in my cupboard and find another motherboard. I'm going to pull that one. I think with the games I want to play on it, if I had a gigabyte minimum, that should be okay. I could probably run a gig and a half, because I do have a 1 gigabyte stick. But memory like that is actually quite expensive, and I'm not sure if it's because these days it's not common now, and getting hard to find, or if they just weren't common types to begin with, because that 1 gigabyte stick I've got is the only one I've actually ever come across. I know they exist, I've seen them on eBay, but then again on eBay, I haven't even seen that many on there. Do excuse my bottom, if you heard that. I've had a bad gut all day. And not just because of wind, I've actually been to the loo several times, and I don't know what the heck I've eaten. But I've been like it since about 4:45 this morning. I swear I might as well just get a laptop and go and camp in the friggin' bathroom. Alright, this is still updating. I know I've got some 256 meg sticks somewhere. Oh, that reminds me, I've got another video card to put in the XP build that I pulled out of that. It's NVIDIA GeForce. Is it a 6500, if I remember correctly? 256 megabytes of onboard memory. It's this one. Why I stuck that one in a Windows Millennium PC, I have no frickin' idea. But, the only reason I opened it up to have a look is because it had the DVI connector on it. So, I've just, I took this out and I plugged the VGA cable into the, onboard VGA socket. So, yeah, the other thing this isn't doing, this isn't allowing me to connect a slave hard drive, because I want to put 2 on here. Because I know those old PC games don't take up a lot of disk space, but I don't want to keep installing and uninstalling and installing every time I want to play a different game. So, the more disk space I can have, the better. I mean, that's 160 gig. It's working absolutely fine. Although, as I'm swapping the motherboard, there's every chance it might throw a wobbly at me. Because I know XP used to bloody do that. At least with me it did. It didn't used to like me changing motherboards. I had a few where they refused to boot. For some reason. I'm just unplugging a few cables. Because, actually, I've got to unplug them. What's that for? Oh! That's the fan cable. That's what it's tucked in there. Tell you what, though. Out of all the computers I've built, this has probably got the best cable management in. Excuse me. So I don't normally bother with cable management because, you know, I've got the attitude out of sight, out of mind. I don't see inside a lot of my cases, so why worry about it? As long as it's not blocking fans or anything like that. Excuse me. You know, and I don't mind cables sort of dangling here, there and everywhere. Anyway, I need to find my screwdriver. The only reason I want to use this specific screwdriver is because it's magnetic. I don't really feel like magnetising another one, although I suppose I could, to be honest. I use, where are they? Are they on this side or are they on the other side? I've got, when I get them off, some hard drive magnets I use to magnetise screwdrivers. Mostly because they're easy to hold, and they're bloody strong. All you do, quickly, before I shut down to go on with a few bits, just do that. And if it's a good strong magnet, you won't have to do it that many times. So that should. There we go. Got a magnetic screwdriver. Now, so I don't go do something stupid with this magnet, such as put it on top of a hard drive, which I have done before. Actually, a flashing beacon like the one down on the floor there. I stuck a magnetic one on top of a hard drive without thinking. I just didn't think about the magnet underneath. And I just went, bonk, straight on top of a hard drive. Yep, and you've guessed it, it did fuck the hard drive. That's a good way to kill the readers on the hard drive. Oops. I couldn't believe I did it, because I knew what magnets did to hard drives. And I just wasn't thinking at the time. I just got this light and I just went to put it on the desk, probably not realising the hard drives were actually there until afterwards, and I heard the clang when I put it down, and I was like, oh bugger. Don't think I lost anything important on the drive anyway. Not that I can remember anyway. Still updating. But at least with that, all I've got to do is I'm just thinking, because if I want to boot the memory up a bit, because apparently that can take a gigabyte of RAM, but I tried that and it didn't like it for some reason. Actually, instead of turning the camera off, should we have a look in the closet here and see if we can find a suitable XP motherboard, or board I could use for it. I could use this one, actually. Just thinking, you know, if I could find the model number and just research it, I'm not really fussed. That's quite a slimline board, though, isn't it? It's not very wide this way. I just have quite a few PCI slots if I ever wanted to upgrade. I've got this one. No, that's too new. That is something like a Vista or a 7 jobby. Now, I've always said I've never liked Vista, but to be honest, I've never really used it.
Duh.
Pardon me. I could use this ASUS board. I think it's an ASUS board, if I remember correctly. It's ASUS. That might actually be a good option, to be honest. I do believe I have got the thingy. Only got the one USB header, and I've got a card reader as well on the front, which I'm the sort of person that if it's there, it's got to work. I don't need the card reader, so I suppose I could use this one, because like I said, I don't need the card reader. I can chuck it or just leave it disconnected. More likely to need the Fujima Flippy Doodity Watts USB ports. I got this one, which is actually untested, so I don't have a processor for it. It's a cartridge type. Could go AMD processor with this one. I know it's an AMD board, but if I remember rightly, that's a gigabyte max. And the fact that ASUS one's got dual RAM channels, I expect that could run a 2 gigs top. But it has got the model number of the board down there, so I can Google it. No, I'm not going to use that one. That can go in the no pile. I'll do this, and I've got to stack them all back in here. Here's another ASUS board. I'm pretty certain, yep, it's got ASUS on it. K8V-MX. is the model number. I've got two slots though, so the memory I've got can only do a gig and a half max. That does have a decent AMD processor in it. And the two USB headers. I'm not sure if I want to go AMD or Intel though, because the processor on the board that's already in there is a 3.2 GHz Intel P4, if I remember correctly. Another AMD board here I could use. But again, only two RAM slots, so although this has SATA ports, so I reckon this would run more than a gigabyte of RAM, but I don't have it. Well, like I said, I've got the gig stick, so I could do a max gig and a half on the board like that. But I don't know what the processor is, and it's probably smaller than what I'd want. No, that one's no good. No good. Because that one, I'm not sure. I think that's AM2 plus. Yeah, that's too new. I wonder if that's the dual core processor I've been looking for. This is one. We have a Prescott. Six USB ports on the back. Nah, I'm not going to use that one. I think I'm going to go with this one, to be honest. Oh, actually, that reminds me, I've got two boards in the cases in the kitchen. Your dipstick, Andy. I've got a Foxconn. I like Foxconn boards. It's got Intel processor on it. Again, not enough slots. I'm gonna go search that one, I think. See, what specs that is. Or what the maximum specs are that it will run. Because pretty certain this is an Asus. Yep, I've just found a thing, it's an Asus. So, you come in here, and I'll put you there, and I'll put this here. I need Google, so we'll bring up a Google, and we'll see if we can find it. What is it? It's an Asus P4R. P4R. It's 800 VM. Yep. 800-VM. You know, I did actually look once upon a time at all the motherboards I owned, and I really should have taken notes down. Here we go. CNET's not, to me, isn't bad for finding out specs of things. They do seem to have fair bit of information. I'm just looking at the photo here just to make sure it is. Turn it the same way as it is in the photo. Everything is identical, so I wonder if there's another USB header hidden on here. This must be a lower model, because there is a lot of pads free on here that aren't occupied that look like they would actually take USB headers. There's another two, actually, and they are labelled USB. Well, one is. The other one isn't. Yes, this must be a lower model. Max mainboard size, micro ATX. Supported RAM, 4 gigs. Ooh. I don't think I'm going to put 4 gigs on it, though. I think I might be pushing it. Although I could do 3.5. So that means each one of these DIMM slots can support 1 gig max. Yet dual channel memory architecture, what's it got? PC1600, PC2100, PC2700 and PC3200. 200, 266, 333 and 400 megahertz. Pretty much all your DDR SDRAM type. Looks like that'll support pretty much all of them. I just read internal as internet. Get my bleeding eyes checked. And the onboard graphics is an ATI Radeon 9100 IGP. Audio is stereo and compliant standards AC97. Ethernet, fast Ethernet, graphics adapter, bloody blah blah, ATI Radeon, you even know that. What does it look like? It's listed some things twice. Either that or it's just my... No, it has listed some things twice. No. I'm going to change it, because it should support the processor I've got as well. So it should just be a case of a straight swap. It doesn't say the actual gigahertz size, but it just says Celeron Pentium 4. Well, for some reason it's got it written twice. Celeron Pentium 4, Celeron Pentium 4. Okay. Yep, so that should run on here. Well, there's only one way to find out. I'll fit it, and it'll either run or it won't. I was all thinking I should have used this one in the first place. Never mind. Oh yeah. I have to go through my box of IO plates and just find one to fit it. Although I think it is just a... No, it isn't. Oh! As soon as I can find the board, have they got a link on here to drivers? No, it's just a specs list. So while I'm here... Server motherboard. Is that really what this was? Really? Well, I'd be a monkey's uncle. According to this, straight from the, what is the website? It says ASUS drivers. According to what I'm reading here, it was a server motherboard. That would actually explain why it's only got the one USB header on it. I'm still going to use it. I can get the drivers anyway. I can get audio drivers, chipset drivers, the LAN. ATI chipsets, and that's it. There's nothing. Well, I don't want the video drivers anyway, because I'm using a NVIDIA video card, which I'll look up later. I'll just get it running on the onboard video for now. Right. Never understood why they did this. A lot of motherboards, you know, they'd have done it so these two blue were one channel and these two black were another channel, but it, very few motherboards have I seen where they've done like two blue, two black. I don't know why they staggered them like that, but I don't know, I suppose that's just what the designers of the board wanted to do at the time, so. Half an hour, right. Well, that's it for this video. I've been a rather busy bumblebee. Just got to finish clearing the bed off, preferably before it gets too late. I need to leave that open. Right. So, thank you for watching if you made it this far. Don't forget to like the button if you like the. Don't forget to like the button. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like the video. If you didn't like the video, then hit the dislike button and tell me how shit it was. It's up to you. And don't forget to subscribe for more of these videos, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.